Well, hello, beautiful. How are you doing today? I'm Jordy from Cinecom.net, and today is going to be a little bit different. You know, a while back we thought about doing a copycat episode from Lock and Key, where you have this ghost effect. Now, the particles around the boy looked pretty good, but the 3D model and its animation... Now, I'm not saying that I can do better, I mean, by far. But anyways, it did inspire me to create my own ghost-leaving body visual. So, I went ahead, tried out some stuff, and I found something that looks pretty okay and it doesn't require advanced effects. That's right, things are gonna be easy. So, let's get started! The first thing you wanna do is film yourself falling on the ground. Then you get back up and pretend like you're floating in the air. And once you get that, we can bring our shot into After Effects. Now place the falling shot on the bottom and on top of there, the shot where you pretend to be a ghost. Then double click on the ghost layer and use the Rotobrush to cut yourself out. And I recommend using the brand new After Effects beta version so that you can use the new Rotobrush. Yo, my name is... I'm your Rotobrush. And I recommend using the After Effects beta version so that you can use the brand new Rotobrush tool, which works very good. Now we made a video about it a few weeks ago, which you can check out up there. Now another way is to use a green screen and key that out when you play your ghost part. That's up to you, both are perfectly fine. So once we have ourselves keyed out, we're going to animate the position so that you float up as you leave your body. Now once you got that, go to the beginning of where you start leaving your body and draw a mask on the ghost clip. Now you want to draw a shape around yourself and animate the mask over time so that it follows you as you fall. The mask will reveal the ghost clip. And of course, you want to feather this a bunch. And if necessary, you can change the mask expansion to match that better with the revealing. And this should already give you that impression like you split your body in two. Good job. Now to make yourself float a little more natural, I'm going to alt-click on the position property and type in an expression in there. Wiggle, open parentheses, 1, which is the speed, comma, 50, which is the position value it can change, and then close parentheses. So this will randomly wiggle your clip on the position property. Alright, we got the bases in place, our ghost is coming out of our body, but of course, it doesn't look like a ghost yet. But before we get into that, I'd first like to thank today's sponsor, which is Storyblocks Video. Now it's an incredible library that we use in almost every project. There's always something that we can find in there, like motion graphics, cartoon animations, After Effects templates, overlays, and so much more. Now for this Friday's project, we're actually working on something pretty amazing that is gonna require a ton of stock clips. And we're able to find everything we need on Storyblocks. They have high quality 4K stock clips in various genres and collections. And what I love the most about Storyblocks is that there's only a single price per year, which allows you to download unlimited video assets. And so that way you can try out different things without having to worry. Definitely make sure to check it out, guys, which you can do by clicking the first link in the description down below. Alright, we can focus on the actual ghost now. Normally you want to work with some sort of a particle effect because we need a disintegration around the edges. But I want to keep this tutorial basic, so I came up with a different way to do this without a particle effect. And by the way, if you do want to learn how to do that with a particle effect, you can check out our Thanos disintegration tutorial in the cards up there. So, what we're gonna do is apply the roughen edges effect to our clip. Then increase the border so that it bites a bit more into the edge. Then set the sharpness to 0 so that it becomes more foggy. And finally decrease the scale to introduce a finer edge or particle. Now to introduce back a little bit more detail, make sure to increase the complexity by 1 or 2. The effect is static, so we're going to animate the evolution over the entire duration of the clip to have it organically move around. Now since I want this disintegration to flow up, I'm also going to animate the offset's Y position from the beginning to the end of the clip. And that's already making us look more like a ghost. But of course, we can do better. So let's add some styling to the ghost. Apply dilumetry and use that to color correct yourself more like a ghost. Now I'm decreasing the temperature, making myself cold and a little bit of the saturation. Now I'm not going to apply a glow effect to the clip because we're gonna do that way differently later on. What I am gonna do is apply the turbulent displace effect to the clip. decrease both the amount and size to introduce a subtle distortion on the ghost. And like before, I'm also going to animate the evolution of this effect over the entire length of the clip to have some sort of an organic movement of this distortion. And that's about it! Now one last thing that I'm gonna do, and that is draw a rough mask around the clip to cut off my feet, because since I'm standing on the floor, that doesn't look so natural. And because this is the second mask, we're gonna have to change the mode to intersect. Man, we're in fire! This is gonna be a really cool effect, guys. So, now that we have the foundation of the ghost effect, we can go ahead and create a ghost cloud around this. Now, to do that, I'm going to duplicate the clip and rename the bottom one to cloud. Now, from the cloud effect, I'm going to change the border of the rough edges a lot. Look at the ghost and try to make a nice cloud around it. And a great tip that I got from Marnik's Darkwinkle was to add a vector blur to it as well. And it's right, I was kind of posting the whole process while making this effect on Instagram, and I got a ton of feedback from you guys, so thank you so much for that. So anyways, what I did was changing the type to perpendicular. And increase the amount. Now this gave a much better result than throwing just a Gaussian blur or something on it. Now to make that cloud hover more above me, I'm going to animate the anchor point. You want to make sure that the motion of this cloud is in sync with your ghost's movement. So you might want to go back and forward a little bit to get it right. And that's it for the cloud. The next thing that I want to do is add some sort of an echo to this effect. So like before, duplicate the original ghost clip and rename the bottom one to echo. And I'm going to offset this clip by a few frames. And that way we get a delayed or an echo clip. And I'm also going to apply the vector blur to this one, change the type to direction center and increase the amount. We're almost there, guys. We have a few more tweaks which are actually gonna be the most awesome. I'm gonna start by duplicating the ghost clip again, and I'm going to name this one Trail. Now on this clip, I'm going to add the CC smear effect. There are two points, one of which I'm going to animate so that it follows my ghost movement, and the other one is going to follow my body falling. Now once my body hits the ground, you can change the point so that it goes back to you, I mean the ghosts. And now don't forget to increase the radius to spread out that smear. Now go back and forward to check how your animation looks and tweak it so that the flow is natural. Now I'm also going to animate the position of this clip so that it fades out on the end. And finally, I've also added a directional blur and change the direction to where my ghost is at. And this brings us to the last step of them all, and that are some opacity and blending mode changes. Now we've got a bunch of layers, and basically what you want to do is change the opacity and blending modes of these layers to make your ghost more transparent and glow. Now not everything has to be the same, and it really depends on your background how you set these. So feel free to change these to your likings. Here is the final result.
Oh snap!
Nah, that was pretty cool, guys. I hope that you've enjoyed it. Let me know what you think of these kind of tutorials for Creative Tuesday in the comments below. And before I forget, there's also a download link in the description to the After Effects project file. Look at that. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. Check those guys out. The first link in the description down below. And as always, stay creative. No idea what I have today, guys, but I'm just super energetic. I think I've got way too much coffee. That's probably it. Yeah, I've got this new coffee brand. No idea what it is. It's just the cheapest coffee in the supermarket, but it is good. It is actually good. I've got this Nespresso thing where you can just put in the pads and make coffee. Good coffee.